Hi, I'm Mara Levine.
And I'm Stuart Markus from Gathering Time.
We're really excited to be performing for you at the San Francisco Free Folk Festival today.
Online.
We hope you enjoy the show. So I'm Mara Levine, and on my right, Stuart Markus. And he's from Long Island, and to his right, Gerry McKeveny, and they're of the band Gathering Time. And we're going to do a show tonight with some music from my recordings and Gathering Time's recordings. And we're going to start off with a wonderful song written by Tommy Sands called Daughters and Sons. Bravely strive to realize the rights of everyone. And though your body's bent and low, a victory you won. For you sowed the seeds of justice in your daughters and your sons.
In your daughters and your sons. Your daughters and your sons. You sowed the seeds of justice in your daughters and your sons.
One can work and children they can play. And though you never got your share of the victories you had won, you sowed the seeds of equality in your daughters and your sons. Everyone.
In your daughters and your sons. Your daughters and your sons. You sowed the seeds of equality in your daughters and your sons. In your daughters and your sons. Your daughters and your sons. You sowed the seeds of equality in your daughters and your sons.
They taunted you in Belfast and they tortured you in Spain. And in that Warsaw ghetto where they tied you up in chains. In Vietnam and Chile where they came with tanks and guns. It's there you sowed the seeds of peace in your daughters and your sons.
In your daughters and your sons. Your daughters and your sons. It's there you sowed the seeds of peace in your daughters and your sons.
Well, now your music's playing and the writing's on the wall. And all the dreams you painted can be seen by one and all. Now you've got them thinking that the future's just begun. For you sowed the seeds of freedom in your daughters and your sons. Everybody.
In your daughters and your sons. Your daughters and your sons. You sowed the seeds of freedom in your daughters and your sons. In your daughters and your sons. Your daughters and your sons. You sow the seeds of freedom in your daughters and your sons.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
So this is one that I wrote. And it appears on Gathering Time's first album. In fact, it was the title track. It's called Songs of Hope and Freedom. And it's a song about the power of music to inspire. The sun in every nation, the hurt in every age, and the brashness of a preacher, guidance of a sage, the hymn of a Christian, the prayer book of a Jew, the Buddhist monk whose saffron robe lies bloodied in the dew. The chance to make life better, the chance to have a choice. The songs of hope and freedom are heard in every voice. The songs of hope and freedom are heard in every voice. Villages and hamlets unknown beyond their walls. When peaceful people hear a cry or hear the timeless call, the suffering of a stranger, or to stand up for their own, to challenge the battalions who stand behind the throne. With a burden and the bondsman, though it's time to take a stand. The songs of hope and freedom are heard in every land. Hope and freedom are heard in every land. With songs like go down roses and like one candle too. Amazing grace and jubilo and glory hallelujah. If this land is your land, a land of liberty, when people suffer anywhere, no one is truly not know the tongue, but still you know the meanings from the way that they are sung. In quiet halls and churches, or confronting a regime, it's what some take for granted, to some is still a dream. In rituals and rallies, in hell of all and never to be still. The songs of hope and freedom are never to be still.
All right, we're going to do another one of my selections. This one, Hallelujah, is on my album Jewels in Harmony, and it is by a wonderful songwriter from the West Coast. Her name is Nancy Cassidy. Usually I say the name first, because when I say Hallelujah, automatically in your mind you're saying Leonard Cohen. Yes. But this one is a wonderful sing-along, and I'm just going to cue you. Each chorus is slightly different and follows the verse, so I hope you guys join us. You guys ready?
I think.
All right. Here we go. One, two, three. The sun is rising on this land. The sun is rising on this land. Rejoicing has begun, a new day's at hand. The sun is rising on this land. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The sun is rising on this land. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The sun is rising on land. Birds are starting to sing. Birds are starting to sing. Rejoicing has begun. Here come peaceful things. Birds are starting to sing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Birds are starting to sing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
sing. Rejoicing has begun, a new day is here. Love's gonna take away our fear. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Love's gonna take away our fear. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Love's gonna take away our fear. The sun rising on this land, the sun is rising on this land. Rejoicing has begun, a new day's at hand. The sun is rising on this land. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The sun is rising on this land. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Birds are starting to sing. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Love, love's gonna take away our fear. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The sun is rising on this land.
Another one that the Gathering Time sort of adopted some years ago, and just sort of fell in love with it, and we made it the opening track of our newest album, which is called Old Friends, and it's all songs from the 60s and 70s that we sort of fell in love with and made our own. And this is one written by Pete Seeger. Not everybody knows that, and a lot of people recorded it, but Pete borrowed the words from the book of Ecclesiastes, which makes it about 2,500 years old, something like that. So I believe that it is the rock and roll hit record with the oldest lyrics ever.
And you say he borrowed them. Did he ever give them back?
Well, they're still in the prayer book. 2, 3, 4.
Season turn, 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 and a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to reap, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to laugh, a time. Everything turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to build up, a time to break down, a time to dance, a time to mourn, a time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together. To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. A time of love, a time of hate, a time of war, a time of peace. A time you may embrace, a time to refrain from.
songs that's been written about the Holocaust. It's called By My Silence, and it's written by songwriters Ellen Bukstel and Nick Annis. And the story about this song is it's based on the Reverend Martin Niemöller, who was a Protestant minister, tried to counsel Hitler, and that did not work. He wound up in concentration camps for 8 years. And Stuart, you can pick up the story.
Well, when he was actually, we visited one of those concentration camps when he toured in Germany about 4 years ago. The Dachau concentration camp was the first one built and became the model for the whole system, and it's outside of Munich. And his cell is highlighted there. It's now turned into a museum and memorial park. And when he was finally freed, he was asked, how did you, a Protestant minister and
Christian citizen,
full-blooded German, end up in a concentration camp? And he gave the famous words, first they came for the communists, and I did not speak out because I was not a communist.
By my silence. I'm not a communist, so when they came for the communists, I held my tongue. Minded my own business like a good neighbor. I trusted that justice was done. I didn't ask what was their crime. It was their sadness, wasn't mine. I didn't care where they were sent. By my silence, I gave my consent. By my silence, I gave my consent. I am not Jewish, and so when they came for the Jews, I had nothing to say. Branded with stars like cattle in boxcars and then taken away. I didn't ask what was their crime. It was their sadness, wasn't mine. I didn't care where they were sent. By my silence, I gave my consent. By my silence, I gave my consent. I didn't care when they came for the unionists, came for the socialists, took the powerless. I'm not a terrorist, I'm not an immigrant, I'm native born, faithfully ignorant. I didn't care what was their crime, till their sorrow turned into mine. Their sorrow turned into mine. I was okay, I was a citizen, and I was free. I didn't care, now there's nobody there, no one to speak out for me. At the time I believed it never
would happen to me. I didn't know what it meant for my silence to give my consent, for my silence to be my consent. By my silence, give my consent. Thank you so much.
We're going to do another one that I wrote, actually, that kind of follows well on the heels of it.
We actually recorded, in 2017, right, we recorded two songs back-to-back,
yes.
By My Silence and...
And Too Far to Turn Back Now, which was the phrase that I came up with. I had a chance to enter a songwriting contest to write the protest anthem for the current age. This was back in 2017 when some hate groups were just sort of feeling suddenly empowered to come out from under their rocks and make their presence known. And something must have happened a few months earlier that started making them feel this way. And I started thinking about the times that America has stood on the side of what was good and what was right, and how we've tackled the evils within our own borders. And the words that came to me were, "We've come too far to turn back now." And we encourage you all to sing along when you get to the appropriate lines. You'll know.
One, two, three.
The wilderness, General Brandy cried, and all the gallant men who died. His eyes at a thousand graves in the great war to free the slaves. But he rose and made a vow, "We've come too far to turn back now. Won't turn back now.
Won't turn back now.
Won't turn back now.
Won't turn back now.
We've come too far to turn back now." Eisenhower paused at all the sacrifices caused. 9,000 men, half a million more, to end a genocidal war. But his task was planning how we'd come too far to turn back now. Won't turn back now.
Won't turn back now.
Back down,
won't turn back down,
won't turn back down. We've come too
In keeping with the, you know, what Stuart was just singing about, my father was an immigrant. He was born in Glasgow, Scotland, 1924.
He's Irish, not Scottish. We just need to make that clear.
Well, and he came to Brooklyn when he was about a year old.
Oh.
And more significantly to this song was that 10 days after his high school graduation, he found himself in Fort Dix, New Jersey, in basic training to be part of the Normandy invasion. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, it's so funny to think, like, you know, they stormed the beach and then they had a smoke, you know, and, but he actually was awarded a Silver Star for something that took place a year later, and which I realized recently was a few days shy of his 21st birthday. So, but the medal was never on display in our home, and he never talked about it, and he never joined the Veterans of Foreign Wars or the AMVETS or, you know, any of that stuff. He just humbly and quietly went about his life. And, you know, in an era where everyone's always drawing attention to themselves and taking credit for things they didn't do and beating their chest, I thought he deserved a song. And so this is called Silver Star. Never talked much to him, then it was too late. So I sift through scatterings in search of clues to this day gathering these precious few. The silver star never saw up to aim a draw. He never drove a new car and rarely went out at night and never asked for one thing for the silver star. He was born the youngest of nine in 24, like the young men of his time fought the big war. Tossed by the merciless tide of history, what he felt inside will remain a mystery. And the silver star never saw daylight. The silver star was tucked away in a drawer. He never drove and rarely went out at night and never asked for one thing for the silver star. What were his dreams and plans? What did he feel when they slipped through his hands? What made him question why? Tucked away in a drawer.
I am a collector and interpreter of music. I'm not a songwriter. And I listen for those real gems. And one of the songs that I recorded on my latest album, Facets of Folk, was written by a wonderful songwriter from Nashville. Her name is Susan Shann. It's called You Reap What You Sow. It's a beautiful message, and it's got a great chorus. I hope everybody sings along with us. Written by Susan Shann. Ready? I once asked the farmer as he toiled in the row to tell me his secret for making things grow. I'll always remember that look in his eye as he studied God's acre and gave his reply. You reap what you sow, so you'd better plan wisely that the harvest may yield you a bounty of good. You get what you give, so give completely, and all your deeds will return as they should. Why he went to such measure to make it the best, without hesitation, without missing a beat, he put that bread in the oven and said these words to me. Everyone, you reap what you sow, so you'd better plan wisely that the harvest may yield you a bounty of good. You get what you give, so and all your deeds will return as they should. So I tended my garden and planted each seed. So you better plan wisely that the harvest may yield you a bounty of good. You get what you give, so give completely, and all your deeds will return as they should. You reap what you sow, so you better plan wisely that the harvest may yield you a bounty of good. What you give, so give completely, and all your deeds will return as they should. All your deeds will return as they should. You reap what you sow, so you'd better plan. Thank you. You Reap What You Sow by Susan Shann. I love the fact that you are sing-along people. You love to sing along. I'm fairly sure that people in this room know Cy Kahn. I had the real honor of having Cy write a song for one of my albums. It's called When I Sing With You. And it's about the joys of singing and harmonizing together and how singing empowers us as a community. When I sing with you, my heart skips a beat. That's what you never do. Your rhythm strong and sweet, each note precisely placed, no matter what the key. I begin to trust when you sing with me. When we sing together, I hear the world anew. When you sing with me, when I sing with you, when you sing with me, each note is fine and round. I lose all sense of time, lost within the sound. Our rhythms circle close, my truest voice breaks through. I am most alive when I sing with you.
When we sing together, I hear
disappointment disappears, the half-truths and the lies, the hard times fall away, my deepest heart goes free. I am most myself when you sing with me.
When we sing together, I hear
song that Peter, Paul, and Mary did. Sometimes Gathering Time has gotten compared to Peter, Paul, and Mary. I'm not quite sure why. I have my theories.
Or CSN.
I'm obviously Mary.
Yes. Because he's got the long hair, you see.
Actually, we did play with Peter Yarrow a couple of times.
Yes. Yes.
When Peter and I first met, he said, "Oh, so you're me." It's all about the height.
This is a song that they did. It was written by Reverend Gerry Davis. It was based on a traditional spiritual, but Reverend Gerry Davis reworked it a bit, and they persuaded him to copyright it. And because of that good advice, when they had a hit with it, Reverend Gerry Davis made enough money to buy a house for the first time in his life, and he was in his 60s at that point. Yes. So he called the song Samson and Delilah. Peter, Paul, and Mary, and Gathering Time calls it If I Had My Way. And when we sing If I Had My Way, I Would Tear This Building Down, just keep in mind we're not referring to this one, but the halls of justice that where justice is certainly weighted a bit more than it should be, and the halls of power that cater to the rights of, or serve some people a whole lot better than others, because we hit it two, three, four.
You read about Samson, read about his birth. He was the strongest man that ever lived on earth. Well, one day old Samson was walking along. He looked down at the ground, he saw an old jawbone. He lifted up that jawbone, swung it over his head. When he got to moving, 10,000 was dead.
If I had my way, if I had my way in this wicked world, if I had my way, I would tear this building down.
Samson and the lion got intact. Samson crawled up on the lion's back. You read about this lion killing man with his paw. Samson grabbed hold of the lion's jaw and he ripped that beast till it was dead. And the beast made honey in the lion's head.
If I had my way, if I had my way in this wicked world, if I had my way, I would tear this building down.
Delilah was a woman, she was fine and fair. She had lovely looks, God knows, and coal black hair. Delilah, she climbed up on Samson's knee. Said, tell me where your strength lies, if you please. She talked so fine, she talked so fair. Samson said, Delilah, cut off my hair. Shake my head just as clean as your hand. And my strength will be like a natural man.
If I had my way, if I had my way in this wicked world, if I had my way, I would tear this building down. If I had my way, if I had my way, if I had my way in this wicked world, if I had
very much.
You reap what you sow, so you've done.